I've scoured my favorite shows and movies for the most full throttle medical scenes. And as a plastic surgeon that's been doing this a long time, 25 plus years, I want to see which ones are realistic and which are bogus. So let's get into it. So this is the show Scrubs with Zach Braff playing JD. This scene is JD's first night on call in his residency or his internship, which is the first year of a residency. So I actually think this has a high degree of validity, you know, obviously sensationalized in some ways, but I can tell you my first night on call is not dissimilar to this. I was at Parkland Hospital, covering Children's Hospital at the time and Parkland. And it's just full throttle. You're running around. You got a million patients to see. You know, there's one scene where he's eating some of this passed out patient's food because, yeah, you can't eat. You never eat. And this scene, he tries to go to sleep. You never got any sleep. You're up all night. And it's just, and then, you know, you go back. At that time, we would do every other night. So, you know, you go next day, you sleep, and then you're back at it. Same thing the next night. So I think this scene is actually very realistic into how it really is for medical residents. I remember just trying to figure out my way around the hospital. This was like a maze, and I had this medical student with me that was really great. And he would really kind of shepherd me around, get me through the shortcuts from Children's Hospital to Parkland Hospital. And then I did my first surgery, which is an appendectomy, with a great guy, Dr. Matt Pompeo, who I operated with. And so I never forget that. It was not dissimilar to what's being shown here.
All right, come forward and turn. All right. Go. And cough.
So this is the great original movie, Hangover. They are such full throttle movies, so funny. So they're talking to this doctor because they went to the ER. They figured out from some little piece of information that they were in the ER. So they go and the doctor's like talking to them about what he saw. But the doctor's examining this older man in the background. No doctor. I mean, you can't, first of all, you can't even do that now. There's a thing called HIPAA. But even back before HIPAA existed, you know, no doctor's going to be doing their exam on a patient while they're talking to some dudes that just came in to ask, hey, what we don't remember what happened last night, you know? So yeah, it's totally bogus. The only thing that's related to medicine is that they're in an ER, and ERs do exist. Other than that, totally bogus. Okay, so this is the series One Tree Hill. It has Paul Johansson playing Dan Scott. So Dan is going to be the recipient of a transplant, a heart transplant. And so what happens is the donor heart comes in, it's in a cooler, but somehow the cooler gets out and then a dog takes the heart. So that part, completely bogus, okay? In transplant, you go actually, there's two teams. One team goes and harvests the organ. So in this case, it could be a heart. And then, yeah, you put that in a cooler and you get in a plane or ambulance and you take it back to where the heart's being transplanted. But first of all, the guy's not sitting in the waiting room. At that time, the person's in the operating room. They're all prepped. Once the heart is deemed to be adequate, then the recipient process starts. So the surgery starts. But let me tell you, there's number one, nobody is gonna drop that cooler. You're not going by McDonald's to get some fries or anything. You just go straight to the hospital and no animals are gonna be feasting on the organs in any of these transplants. I think pretty bogus scene there, but it makes for a good TV series.
Take me up to 300.
300,
you're hot. Clear.
Come on, Rachel, come on.
Nope, not a thing, 205.
Fine.
Okay, so this is the great movie Flatliners. It's got Julia Roberts playing Dr. Rachel Maness. And I mean, this movie, I remember I was in medical school during this movie. So in this scene, she is coded, so her heart stopped, and then there's a power failure. So they can't shock her to bring her heart back. chaos ensues. And I just remember as a medical student, there was another one of the intracardiac needles. And so they were like, intracardiac Bertillium. And like, that was like the end all be all. Like if you do intracardiac Bertillium, you're, and I think they finally are able to resuscitate her back. So that part, I mean, the whole concept, I mean, let's be serious. I mean, really, you're going to, a bunch of medical students are going to, you know, partially kill their friends and then bring them back. That, I mean, that's totally ridiculous. So that's very bogus. But some of the things, you know, restarting the heart by shocking the patient, that is legitimate. And Bertillium is a drug that sometimes is used to resuscitate cardiac arrest. So that is not totally bogus, but the greater concept, pretty bogus. Okay, so oh my God, I feel like Captain Debunker here, but if you like this, check out this video on plastic surgeons debunking the most misleading TikToks.